All right, Joe, you're always talking about staying humble, right? Staying humble. This room, it's a long, narrow room. I watched you kick the tar out of some of your teammates in here, right? But how much does this mean to you right here, this banner, here? Listen. Does this trump the four individual titles? Be honest.
This team title did. And before that, when I first came to college, I was like, man, I didn't care about the team thing at first because I didn't understand how big this can actually mean to you. But this we got this. They had this right at the school, the front of the school when we first got to school, right off the bus. I just thought that was pretty cool that it was like 12 o'clock at night. You know what I mean?
And it was only like a 15-minute drive, yeah, right? Because it was in downtown Cleveland.
They lit up the whole thing for no. It was like really big. I felt like a like a Heat player at the time, or when LeBron was in Heat. It was really cool to see that the school cared and actually cared. And we went down to the locker room, seen all the cheerleaders, all the guys like the cheerleaders on the team and stuff. But we all had they all seen that, and it was cool, man. I should say so. This was a big thing for me, and I'm salty we didn't win it my senior year, but we went out with a bang, and it was a tough team race this year for Division II with St. Cloud in there, Pitt, Johnstown, and us, and Mercyhurst or Marysville. It was a lot of good teams in there this year, so I was happy with second with the team, to be honest. For the first time in my life, I was like, I'm satisfied, you know. We put hard work in there, and we left with no doubt. I could say that each guy on the team was like, I'm pretty happy about going in this tournament. You know, no regrets. We worked hard, shape-wise. We dedicated ourselves to the sport, and we went out. We took second. We were satisfied, I should say. So that was. But winning it this year, my sophomore year, was especially in Cleveland, was probably, I'll never forget that. Most one probably gonna be my best memory in life, especially how it all went down with four champions back to back like that. And
that was, I was doing the broadcast.
Yeah, it was,
and absurd. It was amazing.
It was absurd. I don't know if any team ever done it, something like that. Four back-to-back, starting with 65, 74, 84, or 57, 65, 74, 84, like that.
It was nuts,
yeah.
And then I tell you what, the cherry on top for me was Lineberger. And a match that, like, I thought he was
outmatched. And I had to wrestle that kid in the finals.
Yeah, and you wrestled Mikel up in the finals.
Comes back with vengeance like that, man. I was like, God, Jesus Christ, sport of wrestling is nuts, though. But, yeah, one of the best memories I'll ever have at Notre Dame College.
All right, show me, listen, I like these, they did these, and listen, I don't know, but I know. Anthony Ralph probably got these made.
Yeah, he sure
right? did. Anthony got these made. There you are, right? You got some interesting celebrations, first off.
I think about them a lot. I try not to do the most, but I try to do something different. I try to make wrestling fun. You know, I feel like everybody has the same type of thing. You know, I try to make wrestling like the new thing in town. You know, try to put some flavor into it. Try to make it different. That's the best way to be. You come out having your own different stuff. You know, come out there with some swag. Come out there with some, you know, feeling good, looking good. That's how I learned.
This is the one here. I can see your guys in the background in their singlets. That's in Cleveland. That's when you won the team title.
Yeah, that's when you won the
this
team
title. This is last year.
Last year.
And then show me your freshman year.
Oh, freshman year right here.
Freshman year.
Right about here.
There we
165,
go.
Youngin'.
Were you cutting a lot of weight?
65, no. I wanted to go 74 that year, but coaches told me no. I cut from like 75, I'll say. A good 10.
That's it?
Yeah.
Every week 10?
Every week, yeah. Every
oh, that's
week,
not, yeah, okay, yeah. That's not bad.
Yeah.
And then let's look at, so you got these older ones.
Yeah, these are the legends right here.
These are the guys you're talking.
Primus was nice, I heard. I did a lot of training with him my freshman year.
He's a good top
this guy right here was, man.
Orlando.
My big brother right here. Probably, he helped a lot getting me at Notre Dame. This guy, Dante, is a very good guy too, man. Teaches you a lot in life, and you probably want to, everybody wants to be like Dante in life for a lot of reasons, and this was my training partner right here. He taught me everything mental-wise and with my body-wise, and he's the one. I probably wouldn't be the wrestler I am today if it wasn't for him, just because I seen he's just a freak of nature.
Yeah, he's fighting now. I saw one of his fights.
He's fighting now. Coach Derek Ford, another good legendary wrestler. He's the only national champion I never wrestled with because he was just so big, but.
He's a lot bigger than you, yeah.
A lot bigger. Coach Strawn still comes around. Great guy. I rode around with him a lot. Taught me a lot my freshman year. This guy is the most technical that probably been at Notre Dame, he thinks. But
no, and then your first champ is Victor Crenshaw.
Yeah, and he also came back. You know, he came back around when I was a freshman and sophomore and things like that. Taught me a lot. Told me what to prepare for and things like that. I was always a guy to ask him questions. What should I be prepared for or anything like that? But, yeah, if it wasn't for the history, man, that came through these past couple of years, I wouldn't be the person I am today. So big thanks to all the history.